There's a land that is fairer than day, and by faith we can see it afar. For the Father waits over the way to prepare us a dwelling place there in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore. We shall sing on that beautiful shore the melodious songs of the blessed, and our spirit shall sorrow no more. Not a sigh for the blessing of rest in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore. To our bountiful Father above, we will offer our tribute of praise for the glorious gift of His love and His blessings that hallow our days. And in the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore.
We gather here this afternoon. We gather here to remember before God, Marge Irene Friesen. We're going to have opportunities to give thanks for her life and commend her to our loving God. But we also gather so we can comfort one another. Let us pray. Almighty God, you have blessed us with the hope of eternal life through the death and resurrection of your Son. Look with love on your people who are grieving. We pray that you'd comfort them in their sorrow to make them firm in faith. This we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. I'd like Daryl to come forward to share some of the words.
This remembrance of March will be like my mother's gardening. If it's a good day, we'll get it all done in one shot. If not, we're going to take a break and start again, so please bear with. Margaret Irene Friesen, where do we start? Well, we start in a little farm just outside of Bastrop, Manitoba, where she was born. Mom was 7 out of 13 children who were referred to as his, hers, and ours. She grew up in the Vassar area until she left to go to Kenora to stay with her brother Johnny. From there, she moved to Winnipeg, where she met the love of her life, Boyd, because her sister was dating his brother. They were married shortly after in September 1959. 2 wonderful years later, they welcomed their first child, Gail, into their family. Two wonderful years later, the family grew by 1 with the addition of Ray. Shortly after, they purchased their first home on McLean Street in Winnipeg. A few years later, they moved to a brand new home in a brand new neighborhood on Epsom Crescent. And a couple years later, they welcomed their third child, Daryl, which is me. In 1972, they took a leap of faith. They bought Fireside Inn and moved to Carmen. Once in Carmen, they tried various entrepreneurial ventures. Mom did whatever it took to keep the household going by taking different occupations. Everything from a cook at the Boyne Lodge, real estate agent, and managed various entrepreneurial ventures. Last but not least, Mom did get her Class 1 license and hit the open road with Dad. Mom's perfect driving record was shattered when she decided to go up the off-ramp at highway speed, flipping the truck and spilling the trailer full of nectarines. Thankfully, both were unharmed and the road trips continued. When Dad became ill, retirement set in, and the road trips became camping and adventures. After Dad passed away, the traveling and adventures continued with her brother Mike, and sometimes her brother Larry. Like the Three Amigos, the Three Musketeers, or the Three Stooges, depending on the day. So these trips took to various places, such as Australia, Fiji, New Zealand, Thailand, Philippines, Greece, through the Panama Canal, and across various states and provinces. If you knew Mom, she always had a nose in a book, or her bare feet in the garden, which were her two loves beside her family. Speaking of family, reunions were something that she looked forward to immensely and cherished the memories and couldn't wait to do it all over again. She enjoyed attending various sporting and other events for her children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren. If you knew Mom, she was a caring, compassionate, non-judgmental person that cared deeply for all her family and friends. She took in multiple family members in a time of need to help them get back on their feet or find their new direction in life. She was also a sounding board for all of us, far and wide. She was the rock upon which our family was built. There's that break. And the glue that keeps us together, as shown by all of us here today. As Mom never liked being the center of attention, she would tell all of us not to mope, put a smile on your face, move forward, and live your life to the fullest. We love you, Mom.
The family has chosen various songs throughout the service, so we're going to listen to one of them now.
If I surveyed all the good things that come to me from above, if I count all the blessings from the storehouse of love, I'd simply ask for a favor of Him beyond mortal ken, and I'm sure that He'd grant it again. I want to stroll over heaven with you some glad day, when all our troubles and heartaches are vanished away. Then we'll enjoy the beauty where all things are new. I want to stroll over heaven with you. Places of beauty we long to see here below, but time and treasures have kept us from making plans, as you know. But come the morning of the rapture, together we'll stand anew while I stroll over heaven with you. I want to stroll over heaven with you some glad day, when all our troubles and heartaches are vanished away. Then we'll enjoy the beauty where all things are new. I want to stroll over heaven with you. I want to stroll over heaven with you.
In your bulletin, you'll find Psalm 23 printed, and I invite you, let's read that psalm together. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord my whole life long.
And a reading from Matthew, the 5th chapter. Now when Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. And then he began to speak and taught them, saying, Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be fed. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. Just this last Sunday, that was the gospel reading for us in church for All Saints Sunday. And we remembered on Sunday all those in our lives who have died and played a special part for us in our lives. My mom was one of those that we remember. Especially those who died in the last year, but also those who continue to influence our lives. Just like this afternoon, we gather to remember a saint, as we remember Marge. But not necessarily because she is gone, but because she is still present. And I got some strange looks on Sunday when I said that. But she's present in your mannerisms, and in your genes, and in your lives, and in your present in her. And lives, continues to live, as a blessing. And that's what she was. Marge was a blessing to many, to you as a family, to the community of Carmen. And Jesus says to us, Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Now, you know that blessing is not necessarily something that can be pursued, but it comes as a special gift. In some ways, we might sort of ask this afternoon, well, then why did Jesus name these certain ones in the Beatitudes as blessed? The people Jesus names as blessed are not necessarily people in our world that we consider blessed. But through these Beatitudes, Jesus is not offering a recipe for success or the key to happiness. Rather, he's demonstrating that God does show up just where we least expect God to be in order to give us freely what we can either earn or achieve as blessedness. See, I also think that Jesus chose to lift these up because it's in our moments of disappointment or despair or grief that we're likely to abandon those worlds of stereotypes about blessings, about happiness and wealth and fame and power. And by doing this, then we can be open to the presence of God, the presence that gives without asking anything in return and blesses us so that we might be a blessing. That's what Marge was. She was given to be a blessing so she could bless others. And maybe that's what true blessing is, drawing together as a family, being here for each other, and reminding each other that God promises to walk along with us. God fills brokenness with blessing as we mourn the loss of Marge. And God fills brokenness with blessings when we remember all the good times that we had with her. A well-known story for you this afternoon. There was a traveler who was walking along the road, and he came around the corner and he saw this small sparrow laying on his back with their feet up in the air, legs up in the air. Traveler, curious, said, well, what the heck are you doing laying on your back with your legs in the air? Well, you know, the sky is going to fall. And I'm going to sit here and I'm going to have my legs up in the air so I can hold it up. You can't hold up the sky on those tiny, skinny legs, said the traveler, walking this little bird. Well, the sparrow replied, one does what one can. One does what one can. You said something about that with your mom. So she said, you only do what you can do. It's a little bit of a different wording, but you only do what you can do. And that was Marge. She touched your lives with knowledge and love, with courage and hope, with kindness, and of course, renewed determination. She was that avid reader, which I'm told you did not want to play Scrabble with her as well, because of that. And throughout Marge's life, through her independent nature, her many hours of volunteerism, she did what she could. See, God takes our lives and accepts what we can bring. In other words, we're asked to do what we can. And that's what Marge did every day of her life. May each of you always remember that in life, in death, and especially in pain and sorrow, that you are not alone. For you do have Jesus, the Great Shepherd, here walking right along beside you. Gail, Ray and Daryl, grandchildren, family, and friends, may you know the blessings of God today and the days ahead. Amen. We're going to listen to another song, The Old Rugged Cross. And if you know the words and you want to sing along, please join in with Johnny Cash.
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross, where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown.
To the old rugged cross I will ever be true. It's shame and reproach gladly bear. And you'll call me someday to that home far away, where his glory forever I'll change.
Sing it with us, choir.
So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down.
Everybody sing.
I will cling to the rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown.
I invite you to pray with me. Merciful God, it is you that heal the broken in heart and bind up the wounds of the afflicted. Strengthen us in our weakness, calm our troubled spirits, and dispel our doubts and fears. Holy God, it's you who have made us in your image to reflect your truth and light. Today we give you thanks for Marge, for all the grace and mercy she received from you, for all that was good in her life, for all those memories that we treasure today. We pray that you'd help us now to entrust her to your care, knowing that you are doing for her better than we can desire or pray for. We ask this through Christ our Lord, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. For our table, Grace, just a few announcements. As we go towards the back to have the lunch and the refreshments there, just go straight through, and then this room is going to be transformed into a sitting area for tables and chairs. We're going to do a table of grace that I think you all know. It's Come Lord Jesus, Be Our Guest. And you might have a little bit of a different version than I do, but that's okay. You sing whatever's in your heart there. But we're going to say that together for our table of grace. Come Lord Jesus, be our guest. Let this food to us be blessed. By thy hands be all our food. Thank you, Lord, for daily bread. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Marge. Acknowledge, we pray, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, and into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. Let's go forth in peace and join in a time of fellowship to continue to share memories of Marge.
I don't want to be the kind to hesitate, be too shy, way too late. I don't care what they say other lovers do, I just want to dance with you. I got a feeling that you have a heart like mine, so let it show, let it shine. If we have a chance to make one heart of two, then I just want to dance with you. I want to dance with you, twirl you all around the floor. That's what they intended dancing for, and I just want to dance with you. I want to dance with you, hold you in my arms once more. That's what they invented dancing for, and I just want to dance with you. I caught you looking at me when I looked at you. Yes, I did. Ain't that true? You won't get embarrassed by the things I do. I just want to dance with you. Oh, the boys are playing softly and the girls are too. So am I and so are you. If this was a movie, we'd be right on cue. I just want to dance with you. I want to dance with you. twirl you all around the floor. That's what they intended dancing for, and I just wanna dance with you. I wanna dance with you, hold you in my arms once more. That's what they invented dancing for, and I just wanna dance with you. I just wanna dance with you.